out here, go get the money. So I go get it. Hate means I do something right. So I'ma let him. Yeah, I'ma let him, yeah.
Alright guys, so before we get into today's video, I wanted to talk to you about a product called Hydrix. What Hydrix does is it's a product that helps save athletes' baseballs, lacrosse balls, tennis balls, or field hockey balls. So just by looking at this bucket, it's hard to tell how many baseballs are in here. Now, after going and playing catch with one of your buddies, you could lose maybe one or two baseballs and not know. After putting all the baseballs in, you now know that you have 32 baseballs. After you're done using the baseballs and you're missing some, it's super easy to tell, as you can see here, that you're missing baseballs. Each sleeve holds 4 baseballs on each side and 4 in the center, and the product is really easy to put together and take apart. The product comes in a nice box, and it's also made in the USA. The link to the product will be down in the description below, and if you want 10% off your first purchase, use the code RK02 in the shop. Now let's get back to the video. What's up, vlog? Currently about to fly home at Columbia Airport now. Got 2 hours before the flight. Excited to go back home, see the family, see the friends. I don't know what I'm gonna do for the next 2 hours, because that's what I have until my flight. So maybe sit down and watch some ESPN. But not much else to do, so looks like we'll be doing nothing for a little bit. But I'll see y'all when I get in New York. Alright guys, we got to New York. Going to Lyft now. It's currently 20 degrees outside, but that's not stopping us from going to Lyft. I got a haircut today. Say hello to the vlog, Jeff.
Hi, vlog.
But it's cold outside. There's the snow. Back to the crappy New York weather. But we're going to accelerate. I'm going on my own. All my friends already lifted today, so going to grind on my own. See you guys at accelerate. Alright, just finished my lift. This is the lab, as you would like to call it. I didn't film my stretching because I was listening to music. I'm not allowed to record on my phone while I'm listening to music. I'm not sure how many times I'm gonna film my lifts here, just because it's gonna be so repetitive, and I'm sure y'all don't wanna see only lifting. I'm gonna answer some questions soon as well. They all had on Instagram, Snapchat, but yeah, so. It's a facility. Jeff is currently tormenting me. I'm trying to be quiet because there are games and stuff going on, but they got the hit tracks and stuff set up. So what the hit tracks does is it like monitor the hitting and stuff, but I can't use it since I don't hit. This is the bullpen. Then they got basketball courts down there behind the big field. They also have a track. So this facility is like the nicest of the nice. So it doesn't get any better than this. All right, guys, we're getting a COVID test done. We have to get one because I flew back from South Carolina. I have my negative test here to show them. We have to wear our masks in the car. It's stupid. And I don't have any symptoms, so I don't know why, but it's been a whole mess, and it's just dumb. I want to go back down to South Carolina.
Gotta do it to get your quarantine lifted.
Yeah, we have to do it. My mom is here.
Hey!
We're just kind of waiting, so. We already got yelled at once because we didn't have our masks on in our
own
car.
You didn't, I did.
I did too, the guy yelled at me. I'm gonna try and record getting this thing up my nose, which is a pain, and it feels weird. Hopefully they don't yell at me for doing that. We can't record or take pictures because the state is a joke.
Anything.
This is ridiculous. I don't know why I'm here if I already had a negative test. This is a joke. They have like military personnel here, and they have like state troopers here and all these state officials.
and I already have a negative test. They probably think I have corona, but I really don't. I just tested negative the other day, so I don't know. This is ridiculous, and it pisses me off.
I'm gonna put this right here.
I can't record because they don't support the vlog.
Apparently, well, you're gonna have to open your window so they can stick that thing up your nose.
Apparently, they want us to do a COVID test with the windows up. What a freaking mess this is. Today's a big day, it's a signing party. We got everything set up. It's gonna be a lot of fun, so get to see all the friends and the family. We got the stud, Ryan J.
What up, kid?
Damn, kid. No, but we got the stud signing table. So, it's gonna be a lot of fun. We got the flags. We got three flags. Stud flag. Yo, what are you, Rob Manfred? Yo, Pem's actually a savage. We got Mom.
Hi.
Ja. Yo, stud. Josh is stud. We got a little bit of time before the party starts. I gotta answer some questions that y'all asked. So maybe we'll do that right now. So just get it out of the way and answer some of y'all's questions. All right, first question was from Samuel_Lawner. Said, if you were to get drafted by any team, who would you want to get drafted by? Obviously the Yankees. I've been a lifelong Yankee fan for my whole life. So to get drafted by the Yankees would be a huge honor. We got Hem asked this question, East_Coast_Lumberjacks. Said, what's your ultimate goal? Ultimate goal, obviously, is to make the major leagues, but I mean, obviously you want to go farther than that and be a Hall of Famer and be one of the best of the best. So that's really the end goal, is to be the best possible player that I can be and just put all the work in I can and hopefully reach that goal. A.J_ asked, how do I create so much shoulder hip separation? I mean, honestly, most of it probably came pretty natural, but I do a lot of stretching with my hips and my upper body to create that separation. But like I've talked about in the How to Gain Velocity video, that can pertain to a lot of velocity, and to be able to get a lot of shoulder hip separation is definitely key in the delivery, and that can get you a lot of extra velocity and potentially help you throw more strikes. So having good shoulder hip separation, being flexible is very key in the delivery and something that y'all should definitely work on if you have trouble with it. My boy Billy Vogue asked, if you were to make it to the major leagues, who would you want to strike out the most? I mean, this is kind of tough, but I mean, obviously to be able to strike out like a guy like Mike Trout, who's arguably one of the greatest players ever, and probably, in my opinion, will be the greatest player ever after he retires, would be awesome. I mean, hopefully I wouldn't have to strike out Aaron Judge because I want to be teammates with him, but that'd be a lot of fun to strike out Aaron Judge. But yeah, those two would be a tough at bat, I think. So either one of those two. James Scaps asks, how many max lifts do you incorporate a week? Right now, we kind of just do, we aren't really doing max lifts, it's more max reps. So we do a certain amount of weight for the reps that we do. So we just kind of work up to our max rep or max weight for the amount of reps that are given to us. But normally it's with legs only. We don't really do max upper lifts. So we do max legs probably about two or three times a week. We do three leg days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So normally our max days are Wednesday with the squat and Friday with the deadlift. Sometimes we might do like a max lunge on Monday or something like that, but normally it's Wednesday and Friday. And last question for the day, Nathan.Van05 asked, do you think your showcase team helped you get offers? Absolutely. Going to some of the best tournaments in the country is a lot of fun, and to be able to showcase your skills in front of scouts is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and to be able to have those opportunities with the East Coast Lumberjacks, who I think is one of the best organizations in the country, as far as coaching and player development go. It was, like I said, once in a lifetime opportunity. It's a lot of fun. So if you can get on a team like that, I think it's definitely helpful. You'll develop a lot as a player and as a person, and hopefully you get the chance to play Division I baseball.
Guys, it's late. It's Monday. A lot of work happened this weekend, grinding the editing. I got a new editing system. It'll be good for y'all to see that. That means better quality videos, a lot more effects and edits that I can do with that. It'll be a lot of fun using that. Made some edits this weekend for me and some of my teammates. Roll those clips now.
These ain't no guest jeans. I dropped out of school, I'm still getting mad, but don't test me. I play to the left, they went to the right, they try to
cook that shit up, Quay.
Go to lunch in the Jewish community. I won't tell on the bros for immunity. Can't beat them, that shit ain't gon' ruin me. I'm the only one out that I do me. I got by the group tryna do me. My life like a movie, get hit in the water. Don't got put in no work, that's in order. These things got serious, the millions come plural. I'm living by morals, we swiping and keeping no door. This floor, I'm young and I'm turned, I got the lure. My baby, my wood cost 250, I'm splurging. Got 5 million cash just in case if you merge it. My young, you'll get away, they be purging. It happened like this, I ain't do it on purpose. I'm working, my mood, which one you working? I turned on my coupe, bought a coupe off of verses. I'm tired of these scribbles.
So yeah, those were really fun to make. I'm thinking about maybe opening it up to the public to see if anybody wants an edit. They'd probably cost money, not sure how much I would charge yet. Making a lot of improvements on the vlog, the off-season vlog, so what I'm going to be doing for that is like a separate season, I guess, so it'll be a different season. So once we get back into the spring season, we'll go back to the regular vlogs like what we were doing before, but right now we're going to do the off-season vlogs, which is going to consist of like the videos of me like talking to y'all and lifting and stuff like that. So kind of the same stuff that I've been doing. If y'all have any suggestions, down in the comments below, write them down there, or DM me on Instagram, reach out to me if y'all want to see anything specific. But yeah, that's gonna be the end of the vlog. Thanks for watching. Go follow my socials. My Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter will all be in the end of the video at the bottom. So yeah, stay tuned, keep watching. Peace. Yeah, I'ma let him, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'ma let him. I let him. I hit the nail on the head, yeah. Yeah, I'ma let him. Early bird, go get the worm. Worm in the dirt. I could show you what I'm worth. My hands in the dirt. From where they look when you not. A hand in your purse. Hell, if you think I'm last, hey, last should be first.